This is your life. All the years you have left in the best case scenario. And here we have amount of exercise you do. Ooh. And here is the quality of your sleep. And back there, well, it actually can be quite a lot of things. In 1840, Carl Spengel formulated the law of minimum, which basically says that development and life of the biological system is not dictated by the total amount of the available resources, but by the weakest link, the least available resource. Doesn't matter how good the soil and the sun is, if there's not enough water. And the same law applies to human health. You can have the best diet in the world, an exercise plan, but if you ignore your stress level, or let's say miss a critical blood test like Lp(a), so I have identified 10 most important resources for you, or avenues, to look at. And if you want to live to the maximum of your potential and flourish, you have to be aware of all of them. Some are more obvious, some less, but it's very important not to miss any. And treat this video as a high-level map which should help you to identify those problematic areas. Because remember, you are limited by your weakest link.
Hi, it's a future editing monkey. I was about to watch the last cut of the video before sending it out to the world and internet, and then I decided to do a small experiment. I'm going to watch it together with you. And as we go through each step, I'm going to rate myself. And you can do the same, so by the end of the video, we both know our priorities.
Meet my friend David. He has studied finance since school, followed people like Warren Buffett, took risks, invested smartly, and now he's rich and kind of fulfilled. But how likely do you think he would be in the same place if he was just like, yeah, getting rich is nice, maybe I'll buy a lottery ticket once? The moral of the story is very simple. If you want to get somewhere, you should start taking small steps in that direction. Where the mind goes, the energy flows. So if you want to live above average and have better than average health, it has to be on top of your mind, like how US economy is on top of David's mind every day. You have to commit. You invest some energy today, including watching this video, and that in return will give you decades of extra years and hopefully some fun in the process as well.
Wherever focus goes, energy flows.
The good news is the daily effort doesn't have to be huge, but it's better be consistent. Exponential return is the eighth wonder of the world, according to Einstein, so don't sleep on this power. But do sleep on your bed in the most regular way possible, because it's pretty much your only opportunity to rebuild and revert most of the damage caused by, well, living. Plus, you get smarter when you sleep, you get stronger when you sleep, and you get transferred into the future. So sleep is the foundation for everything else in our list. And of course, I have a separate video about sleep, but let's exercise a bit of patience and get through the whole list first. Well, according to Peter Attia and his Drive podcast, regular exercise is the most effective way to extend the health span.
I think exercise is the single most important longevity drug we have, bar none.
Valter Longo and David Sinclair might pull into different directions, but without any doubt, you have to move and break sweat every single day. This is what humans were built for. In other videos, we'll dive into optimal and shortest routines, but if you just do something, anything, for 40 minutes each day, you'll get 80% of the benefit just like that. And speaking of Valter Longo, have you read the longevity diet book? If you haven't, I'll cover it in a few sentences. And diet is always a hot topic, and it's because it's very hard nowadays to separate the benefits of particular diet from the weight loss or gain it might cause. But if we lean on longevity and science, then we get to something fiber-rich to support gut biodiversity, but keeping blood glucose low, so basically a vegan base, but complemented with moderate or low protein from fish to support the brain and keeping the growth under control. We want to burn long, not fast.
Actually, pescatarian was better than vegetarian. A little bit of meat seemed to help, but it has to be fish.
And fresh, seasonal, minimally processed, basically just follow the evolution and don't stress too much about it. Not stressing in general is a very good idea. It not only extends the length of your life, but also improves the quality of each moment. Whatever spiritual practice suits you, from praying to regular meditation sessions, just go for it. because even as little as 10 minutes a day will already make you so much more grounded and happier person. Been there, done that. We cannot always change what happens out there in the world and to us, but we can always change our mental environment. And this might be underappreciated and under-researched topic, but organizing your work environment so you maybe sit a bit less, home environment to reduce noise pollution and mold exposure, heavy metals and plastic vapors, spending a bit more time outdoors in nature than indoors, all these minor tweaks might be actually very important in supplementing the more common health solutions. Healthy diet is a great thing, but sometimes you got a supplement. Depleted soils, filtered water, spending a lot of time indoors, that all leaves us with some nutritional holes. They're all personal and require some time and effort to uncover. Some might be obvious, like magnesium, and some might be rooted in genetics and require a good doctor and testing to find out. And I do know that finding a good doctor with an investigative mindset is a very tricky proposition. So yes, I do have a guide just for that. But you absolutely need to find somebody who will know your personal history better than anyone else on the internet and will give you appropriate advice based on the experience and the latest science. But you should never forget that number one person responsible for your well-being is you. So you also should keep an eye on the latest science and research. Being educated goes a long way. It will make your life more interesting and will unlock multiple ways to be more productive and maybe even entertaining. Plus, there are a lot of smart hacks out there, which are just so damn useful. From supplementing exercise with sauna to adding mustard seeds to your broccoli, every day brings so many new ways to rig the game in your favor. And you don't need to elevate this process to the meaning of life like I do, but you gotta stay curious.
Stay hungry, stay foolish.
Speaking about the meaning of life, or what I like to call ikigai, which is rooted in Japanese tradition, having one is essential for well-being. It gives you the reason to live in the first place. Plus, it fills you with the true power of gratitude. It's one thing to be grateful for what you have, it's kinda here, but when you feel the gratitude of other people, it puts you all the way, you know, up there. And when the body feels that it's useful to the tribe, it activates all kinds of protective mechanisms.
From a clinical perspective, service to others is really something.
And in a way, that's what I'm doing here. So each comment, each share, that is what fires me up, and that's also what creates a sense of community. Because that is what makes us humans, or as I like to call us, smart monkeys, humans. Doing it together, elevating each other to the next level, and having some fun in the process. That's where social networks can be the power of good for a change. So let's stay connected, comment your thoughts, share this video with friends. The more of us are together, the easier it will be to get to the next level, which ultimately will be the breaking of 120 years limit. And here, I would usually recommend you the next video, but today, I'm going to leave it up to the algorithm and your choice. And would like to sign out saying that aging is bad, dying is stupid, living is smart. So start working on your weakest point today. And I hope to see you soon in the next video.